What is PHP? PHP is a server-side scripting language, which means that it is executed on the server and not on the client computer. It is free and widely used to build dynamic and interactive web applications. Instructions are executed in sequence, starting from top to bottom, line by line. It is not required to compile the code as Java language, for example, because the file is executed by the server. Must have a web server installed, which executes the PHP file. We will use Apache server that comes with the XAMPP package. Make sure that the hosting package where you deploy your web application has Apache server up and running. It is mostly used with HTML pages. When the server receives a PHP request, it reads the file, and wherever it finds PHP code, it executes it and prepares a response to return it to the client. Let's see the whole process in one picture, starting from the client going to the server and the final response back to the client. The client makes the request through his web browser. The request is sent using a PHP file. The server receives the file, processes it, and fetches any database data if required. The request is processed and a response is prepared. The response file is sent to the client. The response file is shown to the user through his web browser. And this is the PHP flow. Now let's see the PHP syntax. This is a simple example of a PHP code. The left angle bracket, the question mark, and the PHP word make the opening tag. Echo is an output statement. Hello, there is a string. It must be within parentheses. Then you have the semicolon, which must be used at the end to end the statement. And finally, question mark and right angle bracket to close the PHP tag. And last, let's talk about the PHP file naming. An example would be index.php. You must use the PHP extension when naming the PHP file, so that the server recognizes it and executes it. If, for example, you use other extensions like .html, then the file won't be executed because the server doesn't know there is PHP file in it. So make sure to always save any file having PHP code in it with a PHP extension so that it can be executed by the server.